Hey everyone, it's Lexie. So we have been living in crazy times right now, just with the quarantine and everything, at least for school. All like the school's basically on lockdown. All our classes have been moved online. So it's been a bit of adjustment, but I'm quite a homebody, so this hasn't been too bad for me. But I know there's been a lot of people struggling with like social distancing and all of that. So here are 10 books to help you get through the quarantine lifestyle that can help kind of help your mind escape from what is going on. So without further ado, let's get started. So this is probably one of my favorite crime series of all time, and there are 6 or 7 books out currently, so you can go and kind of marathon through if you're wanting to. And it is The Girl in the Ice by Robert Reisende, and this is a crime series that takes place in London, and it follows a homicide detective named Erica Foster, and she kind of goes about and solves different murders. I won't spoil too much about this one, but what I really like about these books in particular is that they are very fast paced. The chapters are very short, so it really flies by really quickly, and it keeps you on the edge of your toes. I feel like every chapter, regardless of how short they are, always ends on a cliffhanger, and this one is just really fun to totally invest yourself with. So next I have The Secret Keeper by Kate Morton, and this is a historical fiction novel. It follows this woman who, when she was younger, she had this experience with her mother where this man showed up to their doorstep and their mother stabbed him and killed him, and that was something that was never really talked about in the family. But as their mother is on their deathbed, she kind of brings that up again, and she's trying to put the pieces together and figure out the mystery of her mother's life. So it ties in to London during the Blitz during World War II. And it is just a really crazy book. I loved it so much. It was so engrossing and so atmospheric. And the author does a really good job at weaving in like the present day storyline and the past day storyline. And there's so many twists and turns in here. And this book can totally just suck you in. I remember when I was reading this book is pretty big. It's about 500 pages, and I read it within a day because that's how good it was. It was during the summer, I was outside, and I just completely read it like this. So I definitely, like I recommend any of Kate Morton's book, but this one is particularly fun. So next, this is a book that I am currently reading right now, and I am loving it so far, and it is House of Earth and Blood by Sarah J. Maas, and this is her newest book. It is very, very big. It is just under 800 pages, and it's very different from her current like world, but I think so far, like in terms of like first impressions, like I'm loving this so far. But it basically takes place in the society that's mixed with a bunch of different people. There's humans, there's fae, there's vampires, there's angels, like different people. And this girl named Bryce is half human, half fae, and her best friend ends up getting murdered, and that totally kind of throws her life through a loop. And 2 years later, after the fact, there's a series of murders that take place that follow the same kind of MO as her friend, so she has to kind of help with the investigation. It goes from there. Like I said, I've been very pleasantly surprised by this, and this book is huge. Like, it's quite a bit of a tome, and it will keep you occupied for many, many days. But like I said, I've been pleasantly surprised by this. The first 40 or 50 pages or so are very much info dumpy, and you're very confused, but like once the plot kind of kicks up, it's really, really, you hit the ground running, and I've been loving it so far. I'm about almost halfway through at this point, and like I said, I've been loving it, and I've been pleasantly surprised by it. So keep your eyes peeled for a review coming out very soon. Next, this is a book that I think is very atmospheric, and I feel like a lot of what are people struggling with social distancing, it's just the experiences that we have. And this is one where you can like taste the food that it's talked about. You can really just totally feel like you're there, and it is The Night Circus by Erin Morgenstern. And I read this a few summers ago, and what I really love about this is that it takes place in the late 1800s, following these two magicians that are basically kind of competing against each other in what is known as the Night Circus. And there's a bunch of different storylines that interweave in here, but that's basically it. General synopsis of this, but essentially this book is a lot of fun because it really is so engrossing. Like I said, it's very atmospheric. You could taste the food in here. You could smell the popcorn. You could smell the fire. You can really just picture yourself in this circus. And I think if you can have a book that can really teleport you into these situations, I think it will be like, it will help out a lot. And you can kind of get the kind of that feeling like you are kind of traveling along with these characters as well. So this is a book that really helped me when I was needing that escape, and this is what I read went right after my grandmother had passed away, and this was really, it was really beneficial for me because it provided me with that escape to kind of actually like kind of just forget about what was going on in the world around me and just really engross myself in the lives of these characters. And it is The Alice Network by Kate Quinn, and this is another historical fiction World War II novel that actually is World War I and World War II. So it follows two women. We follow Charlie, who is in post-World War II. She is pregnant and she's trying to figure out what happened to her cousin Rose, who went missing during World War II. So when she gets to London, she's trying to find out, and she ends up what happened to her cousin, and she ends up crossing paths with Eve, who is a former World War One spy, and their paths kind of cross. But what's unique about this is that they're in like the present day storyline, as they're trying to figure out what happened to Rose, we get flashbacks of Eve's experience in World War One being a spy. And this book was so amazing, the relationship between these two women, and you can see them grow throughout the whole novel, was just really spectacular. And like I said, this book really provided me with that escape, and I think a lot of you would really enjoy that as well. This is another atmospheric read that I think you guys would really like, and it is The Bear and the Nightingale by Catherine Arden, and this is based off of Russian folklore, and it follows this girl named Vasilia, who is kind of like an in-between person. She is human, but she could bridge the gap between the spirit world. She's very much very in tuned with the Russian like spirits, like the house spirits and all that. And while this is going on, there is the bear essentially, which is a bad spirit that's wrecking havoc in the human world, and it kind of takes off from there. But like I said, this book was so atmospheric. It takes place in Russia during the Middle Ages, and you can just totally see yourself in these cold woods, just totally immersed in the world. This one is a little bit of a slow burn. For the first 100 pages or so, it's really setting up this world, the spirits, kind of understanding that, and it's a little bit slow, and I was very much convinced I was going to DNF it. But once I got over that hurdle, you really get sucked into the storyline. This is probably one of my favorite trilogies of all time, and it was just so good. Each book gets better and better, and like I said, if you're struggling with this, like, get over that initial hurdle, and it's just like, oh my god, this book, the series is amazing, and I cannot stress it enough. So this is a book that I've been talking about a lot recently because I read it a few years ago, forgot about it, and reread it with my aunt, and I just totally forgot how much I love this one, so I have to make up for lost time. And it is Lilac Girls by Martha Hall Kelly. I already talked too much about this book already on my channel, but essentially the plot is it follows three women over the course of World War II. You can tell I do really like my World War II books. But essentially for this one, it takes place, like I said, in World War II. We follow Caroline, who is a socialite in New York. We follow Kasia, who is a woman growing up in Poland. And then we also follow Herta, who is one of the concentration camps, like doctors that did the experiments on women at Ravensbrück. So it follows these three women's stories and how they intersect throughout the war. And there's something about this author's writing that is totally engrossing and sucks you in. And I think there is something really special about that. Like, I could just sit down, read, look up at the time, and be like, oh my god, I read 50 pages and it didn't feel like that. So I think there's something really special about this, and I think this is the perfect book to lose yourself in during these times. So this is the last World War II book on this list, I promise, and it is The Nightingale by Kristen Hannah. I read this book when it initially came out 5 or 6 years ago, and I love it. I haven't read it since, but I definitely have been getting the urge to reread it very soon. And essentially it follows two women over the course of World War II during the France invasion by the Nazis. And so it follows each sister's different like experience during the war. One, the older sister, she has to open her house to a Nazi official, and the other one very much gets involved in kind of the rebellion, and it just kind of goes off from there. But this book is so powerful, and I really like how it showcases the female experience during war, but it also really shows the bonds between sisters and how important it is to tell women's story and stories, I should say. And yeah, like I said, I cried over this book. It is so beautiful. It's very, like, it's very powerful, and it just will pull at your heartstrings. So this is, again, another one of my favorite more recent crime series, and it is Blood on the Tracks by Barbara Nicholas, and this is the first book in the Sydney Parnell series, and it basically follows Sydney, who is a former Marine who is essentially like a cop for the railroads and like security and all that, and she has a canine companion, Clyde, who was also in Afghanistan with her, but she ends up getting involved in a murder investigation. It goes off from there, but what I really like about the series is not only is Sydney such a complex and dynamic character, but this book also sheds light on PTSD and how people who come back from war don't necessarily get the resources that they need in order to kind of help kind of adjust back to civilian life, and I really like how it showcases that. So this book was just truly phenomenal. I love this series. I think they have the new book, the fourth book, coming out in June, so this is definitely, you can marathon like the three books that are currently out now. They each get better and better, so like I said, I love this series. And lastly, I feel like this is a book that needs to be added to this list. Not only is it an amazing trilogy, but I feel like it very much draws parallels to what is going on in the world right now, and it is the Year One trilogy by Nora Roberts. So this book basically takes place in our world, but integrates Nora Roberts' magic system. So basically there is this deadly kind of almost like virus that goes around and wipes out two-thirds of the world's population, and this virus is spread through dark blood magic, and so those who have magic in them are those who are immune to this kind of virus, and you can see how that can cause some problems, and it kind of takes off from there. This first book is very much laying down the world, the current state of the world and what is going on, and it draws a lot of parallels to what is going on. Obviously there's no magic aspect in what is going on right now, but I think it's very interesting because you can definitely relate to aspects in here, especially with what's going on now. But I really love this. Like I said, this one is very much foundational, setting up the world, setting up the plot, and the second book and third book are just amazing. So like I said, if you're looking at something that's very much reminiscent of our times right now, I highly recommend you pick this one up. So that's it, guys. Thank you guys so much for watching. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Let me know in the comments below if you have any self-distancing quarantine books recommendations that you think other people would enjoy. You can have them all listed down below. I think we can help each other out during these kind of strange and historic times. But yeah, thank you guys so much for watching. Don't forget to give this video a thumbs up, and I will see you guys next time. Bye guys.